Good day to everyone who's watching. In our lesson 2 of simultaneous equations, we're going to talk about the method of matrix. Now, this method of matrix, we are going to form matrices from our simultaneous equations that are given. So how do we form? Forming the matrices, that is going to be our step 1. We just get the coefficients the way they are there with their signs. That is a 3. Coefficients of unknowns, that's a 3. Then this one there, there is a negative 1. This one here, there is a positive 2. That one there, there is a 5. Then times the first unknown there was what? Was m, and then n, and then this one here is 5, then 7. Then this method requires you to be knowing the matrix multiplication. Then we need to get the adjoints of this matrix here. So adjoints of 3, negative 1, 2, 5 is going to be equal to. To get the adjoints, very easy, we interchange elements in the leading diagonal. So that's going to be a 5, and that one becomes a 3. Then we change the signs of those in the minor diagonal. That's going to be positive 1, and this one here becomes negative a 2. Now, I get this adjoint, then I left multiply it in this equation here. So this is going to be 5, 1, negative 2, 3, then times the 3, negative 1, 2, 5, then times mn is equal to, because I said left multiplying on both sides of that equation there. So this is times the 5, 7. So we are going to multiply matrices this side and also multiply these two matrices here. So row by column, as I'm adding, this times that is going to be 15, plus this times that is going to be 2. Then row by column again, as I'm adding, this is negative 5 plus positive 5. Row by column, as I'm adding, this is negative 6 plus, this times that is positive 6. Row by that column, as I'm adding, that is positive 2 plus, this times that, 3 times 5 is a 15. Then times my m, n, is equal to row by column, as I'm adding, and this is going to be 25 plus 7. Row by column, as I'm adding, this is going to be negative 10 plus that is 21. Then now I add here, when I add, I have 17. When I add here, I have a 0. When I add here, I have that is a 0 again. When I add here, I have a 17. Then times the m, n, this one is going to be equal to, when I add here, I have 33. When I add here, I have, that is going to be positive 11. Then I multiply row by column here. So that is 17m plus 0n, which is 17n. Then row by column here, this one is 17m. Then I multiply row by column here, 0m plus 17n, which is 17n, is equal to 33, then 11. But this one here is 32. So now I have equal matrices. Remember the topic of matrices. If they are equal, that means that this corresponds to that. So that means that the 17m is equal to 30 what? 32. Then I divide both sides by 17 and that side by 17. I finally get M as 32 all over 17. Then here 17N is equivalent to 11. Then I divide both sides by 17 and that way by 17. So I get N as 11 all over the 17. My values of M and what? And N. Remember, we say that we can get answers which are fractions. Then another thing to note is that when you multiply here, when you multiply there, you must see that these values here are the same. Then those ones there in the minor diagonal, they are zeros. So if you are not getting zeros, don't force them to be zeros. That means that you made a mistake here, either to get the adjoint or a mistake here while multiplying such that to come up with that matrix there. So our example 2, we have there a plus 4b is equal to 6, then 8b minus a is equal to negative 3. Like we said, like the former example, you need to extract out the matrices or to form the matrices within the simultaneous equations. Now, when you look at this equation 2, you can see that this is 8b minus A. So you need to first make sure that these unknowns there are linked, as in that is the A there and the unknown down here is also A. So this one here, I can rewrite it as negative A plus 8B to give me negative what? Negative 3. Now I can form equations. I can form matrices in those two equations. So the coefficient here is 1, the coefficient here is a 4, coefficient here is negative 1, coefficient here is positive 8, times the first unknown there is A, the second one is B, is equal to, this one here is 6 and negative what? Negative 3. After forming the matrices, please you get the adjoint of this. So adjoints, 1, 4, negative 1, 8 is equal to, I'm going to interchange those in the leading diagonal, 8, 1, those in the minor diagonal change sign, positive 1, negative what? Negative 4. Then the third step after getting the adjoint, please left multiply that adjoint on both sides of this equation here. So that one is going to be 8, negative 4, 1, 1, times the 1, 4, negative 1, 8. Then times my FB, then is equal to the 8, negative 4, 1, 1, times the 6 and negative what? Negative 3 there. Then I'm going to start multiplying. You multiply these matrices and that matrix that side. Row by column, as I'm adding, that is going to be 8 plus positive 4. Because negative, negative, negative times a negative, we get a positive. Then row by column, as I add, that one's going to be 32 then plus negative 32. Row by column, that one is 1 plus negative 1. Row by column, that one is 4 plus 8. And then times A, B is equal to row by column here, that one 6 times 8 is 48 plus negative 4 times negative 3 is positive 12. 1 times 6, 6 plus the negative what? Negative 3. Then when I add here, I have the 12. When I add there, I have a 0. When I add here, 0. Add there, 12 times FB is equal to, when I add there, I have 36 there. It is a 6 there. The 8 to 8 is 10. Then 20. Then 20 plus 40, that is the 60. Then here I have negative, I have positive 3. Then now I multiply here these matrices again. So this one is going to be 12A and then 12 what? 12B. Row by column, 12A plus 0B, which is 12A. 0A times 12B, which is 12B. Is equal to 6, 10, and then what? And then a 3. Then now I can equate because I have two equal matrices. So that means that the 12A is equivalent to 60. Then I divide both sides by 12 and that way by 12 to get the value of A as, when I first reduce by 6, I get a 10. When I reduce by 6, I get a 2. When I divide, I'll be getting A as what? A as 5. Now, lastly, 12B is equal to a 3. Then I divide both sides by 12, and that way by what? By 12. So I have the value of B when I reduce by 3, that's 1. And by 3 down, that is what? That is 4. So my A is 5, and then my B is a quarter. My example 3, I have 2w plus 3x minus 13 is equal to 0. X plus 5w minus 13 is equal to 0. Now here, our constants, they have been taken this side. So I need to first reverse them back to the other side, such that I can only have unknowns this side, then the constants, the other side of the equation. They also interchange w and x, such that they can be aligned. Want WW down here, then XX down there. So this is going to be 2X, rewriting the equation 1, rewriting my equation 1. And this one here is equation 1, equation 2. So this is going to be equal to 13, because crossing equal sign will become a positive. Then 5W, then plus X, this one is going to give me positive 13. Now forming my matrix, that is 2, positive 3, positive 5, positive 1, times the first unknown there is W, then followed by X is equal to 13, and then 13. Then I get the adjoint of this matrix here, adjoint. equal to, I interchange that 1 and 2, then I change the signs there, negative 3, then negative 1, negative 5. I continue as before, multiplying the adjoint, then multiply the adjoint back here in this equation here. So this is going to be 1, negative 3, negative 5, 2, then times 2, 3, 5, 1, then times Wx is equal to, this is 1, negative 3, negative 5, 2, then times 13, 13. Then I multiply this side row by column as I'm adding, that's going to be a 2 plus. This one is going to be negative 5 row by column. As I add, this one here is going to be a 3 plus negative 3 row by column. As I add, negative 10 plus positive 10 row by column. As I add, this one is going to be negative 15 plus positive 2. Then times my Wx is equal to, I multiply the other side also, row by column, this is 13 plus, when I multiply there, negative 3 times 13, when you multiply, that's going to be 13, negative 30 what? 39, row by column, as I add, that one's going to be 50 plus the 15, that one's going to be negative 65. Then that one there, when I add, when I multiply, I have the 20 what? The 26. So when I add here, I have the negative 13. Then here the 0. That one is a 0. Negative 13 times Wx. This one is going to give me, when I add there, when I subtract 13, so this one here is a 6, and that one here is a 2, so I get negative 20 what? 26, because the 36 was the one which was a negative. So I get negative 26. Then when I subtract there, I subtract there, I have negative 39. Cross multiplying, sorry, not cross multiplying, but row by column, as I'm adding, that's going to be negative 36W, negative, negative 13W, negative 13X, then is equal to my negative 26, negative 30 what? 39. Then I have equal matrices. I equate negative 13W is equal to negative 26. Then I divide both sides by negative 13 and divide this side by negative 13. So W is going to be equal to, when I divide there, I get positive 2. Then even here, negative 13x is equal to the negative 39. I divide both sides here by negative 13, negative 13, and even this side by negative 13, I get the x value as the 3. So my x is positive 3, and my w is positive 2. So looking at the graphical method, solve the following simultaneous equations using the graphical method. So you need to be having a squared book, that is a graph book, where you're going to be doing these examples from. So for me, I'm going to be guiding you here, as for you, you are doing the work into the graphical work. So I'll be using my blackboard. I know it is not squared, but you use the graph book. So step one, what we do is to generate generate 2 points such that we can plot these two equations. So we have equation one and then equation two. Generating 2 points from this equation three, that is 3x plus y is equal to 6. So I can draw my simple box having x and then y there. Then now, suppose my y is equal to 0 and I substitute it there, 3x plus 0 is equal to 6. This is going to be 3x is equal to 6, divide both sides by 3, and then I get my y value as what? Sorry, x value as 2. So when y is 0, x is a what? X is a 2. Then I need to generate also another point. Suppose if I make x 0, if my x is 0 and I substitute it in that equation, what will be my y value? So this is 3x plus y is equal to 6. I'll say this is going to be 0. 3 times 0 plus y is equal to 6. This is 0 plus y is equal to 6. Y is equal to 6. So this one here, if my x is 0, my y is 6, then I'll be plotting these 2 points here. That is 20, then 06. Then I go to line equation 2. So that is y minus x minus y is equal to a 2. So again here, if my x is 0, suppose my x is 0, I substitute there, so that's going to be 0 minus y is equal to a 2, this is negative y is equal to a 2, then divide both sides by negative 1, negative 1, I get y value as a negative a 2. So if my x is 0, then my y is 2. Then again, if my y is 0, I substitute there, x minus 0 is equal to a 2, x is going to be equal to 0. So if my y is a 0, x is a 2, then I'm also going to plot that line. I plot this, I plot that. Where the two meet, the point of intersection is the one that is going to give me the solution to these two simultaneous equations. Thank you. scale, our scale here we can use is 2 centimeters, represent 1 unit. What do I mean? I mean 2 boxes. So when you have your squared paper, after drawing the y-axis and the x-axis, please use two boxes. That is the 2 centimeter to represent 1 unit. That is from 0. I skip 2 boxes. The next second box, that's my 1, then a 2, then a 3. Continue skipping like that. 4, 5, then 6. Down this way is where you find the negatives. Negative 1, skip 2 boxes, negative 2, negative what? Negative 3. Then this side of the x, that's where we have the negatives. So I label, that is 1, that is 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and so many others. Now I start plotting the first line. The point here is 2, 0, and also another point there is 0, 6. Here I'm having 0, -2, and also I'm having there 2, 0. So I first start with this one here, 2, 0. X is 2, y is 0, is this point here. On the x axis, all y values are always 0. So that is the point. I put a dot and a small circle. Then I try to plot that one there, 0, 6. X is 0, y is 6. On the y axis, all y x values, they are 0. Then I join to form a line. Then I get my ruler, I put there in those two. I join. After drawing the line, I label it that line there is 3x plus y is equal to a 6. Some of you get excited. When you draw the line, you just get excited and you forget to label the line. This is when you draw the line, label it that this line is called so and so. Then I go here, the next, 0, -2, that is it, x is 0, y is -2, that is it. Then 2, 0 is here. Then I also join the 2 points to form my line. So I join the 2 to form my line, and also I label that this one here is x minus y is equal to 2. Then we have seen where the two lines meet, that point of intersection becomes the solution to the simultaneous equation. So these two lines meet at this point, which is 2, 0. Therefore, the x value there is 2, and the y value there is 0. So I have solved the two simultaneous equations graphically. To repeat for you the procedures, we have said you need to generate these 2 points here. You generate each equation, you generate 2 points. They're just enough to draw a line. After drawing the line, you need to draw them, plot those points there, then join to form a line. After joining the line, you label the line. You do the same for the other one. Then the point of intersection becomes the solution to those unknowns there given in the question. So my example two, x plus y is equal to 8. Then 2x plus 3y is equal to 14. We say you generate 2 points for those two equations there. Suppose my x is 0, x plus 2y is equal to 8. This one is going to be 0 plus 2y is equal to 8. And then 2y is equal to 8. Divide both sides by 2. You get the y value as 4. So if x is 0, y is what? Y is 4. Then again, I do the same thing. If my y is 0, I substitute there, that's going to be x plus 0 is equal to the 8. So x is going to be equal to 8. So here I put the 0, y, then the 8x. So again, for the second one, if my y is 0 there, the 2x, y is 0, the 2x plus 3y is equal to 14. When I put the 0 there, that one's going to be 0. 2x is going to be equal to 14. Therefore, I end up getting the value of x as 7. So if y is 0, x is what? X is 7. Now, here someone can say, you are going to now say, if my x now is 0, you see that we will not go into the 14, then we find a way out. So I can make this y to be a 2. No, because I want now to be generated. First I got that one there. Now I need to get this one here. So if I make this one the x, suppose I make it a 3, no, suppose I make it a 4, I'll be happy if my x is equal to a 4, when I substitute here, that's going to be 2 times 4 plus 3y is equal to 14. This one here is 8 plus 3y is equal to 14. Then taking 14 the other side, this is 3y is equal to 14 minus 8. When I subtract, I'll be having a 6 and I get my y value as a 2. So if my x is 4, y is a what? Y is a 2. Now, I want you to plot this using the same scale. 2 centimeters represent 1 unit, such that you can get for me the solution to this one. I've generated for you the points there. I've generated for you the points here. Then I want you to plot. You draw the y axis, you draw the x axis. You label the axis y, axis x, axis, then you put, skip through 2 boxes, then you plot those points there, you draw the line, you label it, you draw even this one, you draw the line, you label it, and then you tell me the points of intersection. Now I'm going to leave you with an exercise.